So now let us look into how to preview the data once the RDD is created. Before getting into that, let's review how to access the documentation. Even at the time of certification, they will provide you the access to the documentation, whatever version of Spark they mentioned as part of the published curriculum. They will be providing access to the documentation. So all the certifications that are conducted currently are primarily on Spark 1.6.2. Okay, 1.6.2 or 6.3. There is not much differences between the two. Okay, and most likely they will provide you either a bookmark to the official documentation, or they download the official documentation and provide you on the desktop. It could be anyway. So now if you go here, the main thing which you need to focus from now going forward is the transformations and actions. You should know as many as possible as you proceed further. And also, even if you don't know all the transformations and actions, if required, based upon certain questions, you should be capable enough to go through the documentation and prepare accordingly. Okay, so I am going to transformations and actions here. Even for the past topics such as creating the RDDs and all, there are certain examples here, RDD operations. So even transformations and actions are considered operations on RDDs themselves. So you should know these things a bit in detail. So now I am actually taking you to transformations and actions, and the APIs such as first, take, collect, count, etc. can be used to preview the data. Okay, so that being said, let me zoom in a bit here. Yeah, so these are the actions. Let's talk about the collect, count, first and take, and even take sample. You can actually try to explore these things, but I will be primarily focusing on collect, count, first and take for now. These can be used to preview the data. Okay, so that being said, let me open our Sublime Text. Already we have command which can be used to create RDD. So I'm copying this thing, and as part of the certification, make sure you follow the instructions and create as many files as you want using Sublime Text if you have to save the code also. So you need to understand what they are asking as part of the problem statement, and you have to act accordingly. If they ask you to preserve the code somewhere, you have to do that. Okay, so these are the different commands. Already we have seen first to preview the data earlier, just to validate the path. If you use take of 100, it will fetch 100 records from the RDD, the first 100, and create an array out of it. And collect also creates array out of it. So the advantage of converting RDD into array is you can use rich Scala collections API on the final output if it is required. In most of the cases, just using take or collect is not a good idea except for previewing the data. Your final code should not use take or collect or first unless and until you need to take certain action after converting into an array. But before getting into transformations which are considered to be deeper, you should be able to preview the data so that you can understand how the data look like, so that you can start coding. Okay, so here I am copying this one. Uh, and pasting it here. There is a Scala context already, which is launched using Spark Shell command. And then I can type as well, orders.first will give the first record. Each element in RDD is of type string. As we are only getting one element, the return type is the type of each element in the RDD. And if you want to get first 100 records just to preview the data, you can say orders.takeoff100, and you can see the data here, and you can see whatever is returned because of orders.takeoff100 is nothing but of type array, and each element is of type string. After getting the first 100 records, if you want to print, you can use for each println. So for each takes a function as argument. In this case, println is the function which will print each and every element separately. So just for the preview purpose, I'm just using 10 instead of 100 so that we can see the 10 records by using take as function which converts into an array. So for any reason, if you just want to preview the data by printing, this is the approach which you need to follow. Okay, same is the case with collect, but you should be very careful using collect, because collect will convert a multi threaded distributed RDD into a single threaded array. And even if RDD is 10 gigabytes, when we try to process the data, the 10 gigabytes will be distributed into partitions, and each partition will be processed by one task. So a 10 GB data will be distributed into 80 partitions by default. As it is distributed, running into out of memory issues is very unlikely. Whereas if you try to use collect, it will actually fetch all the 10 GB data from this distributed partitions of RDD, and it will create a single threaded array, and you might start getting into out of memory issues, etc. So make sure you are very careful while using collect. As long as the data is short, you can use collect in some cases, otherwise don't use collect at all. On top of these things, you can use orders.count to get the number of records. There are 68,883 records in this. And on top of these things, there are other APIs also under actions, such as count by key. This for each is different. You should not use for each on top of RDD and try to print. It will not work. It is different. This is usually done for side effects such as updating an accumulator or interacting with external storage systems. We should not use for each to print on RDD directly to print the contents of RDD. Either you have to use take or collect first to convert RDD into an array, and then you can use for each on array to print the results. Okay. For example, if I just say orders.forEach println, our orders is RDD. Okay, and you can see that it is not printing anything. So you should not use for each directly on the RDD. You have to convert into an array. So you have to be a bit careful with that. Okay, and then there are certain APIs very, very important, such as save as text file, save as sequence file, save as object file, to preserve our output into underlying file system. We will defer the discussion of those of that for now. We will cover how to save into different file formats a bit later. For now, we will limit our discussion to APIs which can be used to preview the data, such as collect, count, first, and take. And also you can give try on take sample if you want, and also take ordered to get the data in sorting order. But these are not that important, but for certification purposes, these four are a bit important, and you should know how to use them.